And so we go to the final game of the Heinki Does Deus Ex game block. And now it's going to be Human Revolution. The other game. Well, nice that I love that. For some reason, Mankind Divided is really, really buggy with its saves. So right now, I can't play another game, and Steam crashes because it's still trying to load and upload the Steam Cloud data from Mankind Divided. That's how well programmed it is.
I see splits.
Oh, you see splits. The awesome splits. Hello, please change the scene. There you go. Da 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 da. Hero, human revolution, hero revolution, what? No, it's not entirely right. But yeah, welcome to Human Revolution, the last run. Alright. Hello, Splits. So, what I said before, we're using a pre-made save here. Oh yeah, I need to have DX story on. Basically, the game needs a frame limiter, otherwise, well, I could do this thing, but we found out that the best frame limiter to have of this is 60. No, it's 80. And so I'm just going to start DX story to capture it. 80, there you go. Alright. So be ready on time in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Human Revolution with Heinki. Oh boy. So yeah, this is Human Revolution. The previous game before Mankind Divided happened. So this is like the moment where Jensen isn't even augmented. Oh yeah, and we play the game in French because the French version is 12 seconds faster. Deus Ex turn. Singapore. Yes. Singapore is going to happen later though. Psh, don't spoil it, Sonic. And the coolest thing is, there is going to be the first glitch already at the start. So we go over here. Oh yeah, and there's another trick I can do. It's called like the sprint jumping. I can pop, say hi to T-Pose Barrett. Love that figure. But yeah, what are you going to see what I'm doing here right now is called the sprint jumping. So normally the stamina would go to zero and then you can't run fast anymore. However, if you jump in midair, your velocity stays the same, so you can still go fast, which is really nice, and that's what we're pretty much abusing here. So we have like all the time the maximum speed. It doesn't save that much per level, like around 1 to 2 seconds. But if you do it in all the stages perfectly, or like all the time, you can save around 9 to 10 seconds. So it's like a pretty nice save up, just to have it. Here's another clip coming up. Let's see if that works. Ah, too bad. Okay, we have to wait. It doesn't matter, it's like a really hard trick. If you can do it, you save 10 seconds. If you can't, well, it's fine too. Just takes longer. Now we go around here. Oh no! The guards, they see me! What should I do? Doesn't matter, because we're skipping this. Thanks for the good luck and have fun. So now we're super augmented Jensen. Basically, we got augmented now, and we're going to be pretty broken later on. Like, we use a lot of augmentations once again. But here we are going to use a bit of more cooler tricks. There's way more nice tricks which we'll be abusing. Okay, this is Pictured. He comes back in Mankind Divided, one of the DLCs, but you don't see him at all in Mankind Divided. Mon amplificateur rétinien fait des siennes. Vous pouvez le réparer? Either way, this is pretty simple. So this is one of the cutscenes we can't skip yet, so we just need to listen to it. Blah blah blah. Votre soin sentinelle va s'activer et réparer les dégâts éventuels. Votre affichage rétinien est bon pour le service. Le programme de reconnaissance ne repérera pas encore les ennemis, mais vous devriez avoir le radar et le réticule de visée. Les données biomédicales aussi en cas de douleur. Bon. Vous avez fini? French version. Yeah, the French version is assassin faster. Des intégristes se sont introduits dans notre usine et ils ont pris des otages. Peut-être que cette fois vous sauverez quelqu'un. Lucky for you, I'm gonna ignore it. Je vais faire comme si je n'avais rien entendu. No awesome Jensen English voice repeat. But either way. Director's cut in March? Why in March? I mean, you can run it right now. And the run is pretty similar, only that the director's cut version has the missing link included. And the missing link is pretty cool. Like, on its own, the missing link has a really cool speedrun. The only reason I dislike the director's cut is because of one mission which takes 6 minutes running back and forth. You literally do nothing else. And that is really annoying in my opinion. So we take lethal and short range. We want to have a revolver, because the revolver in this game is really overpowered. And we're going to love boxes. So I'm going to throw this box at myself, clip through, out of bounds, whee! And this saves a lot of time, like around 10 seconds, because we don't need to go around and the enemies don't spawn. Like, this entire passage is now free. We can just walk here. It's really handy. So we go over here, take this blinding grenade. This guy wants to talk with us, or wants to see us, but we don't want him to see us. And now we just leave. Bye. And let me go here. Don't need the pistol yet. The code for this is 1337. Take the box. Go to the door, align to the door, throw it on myself, and bam, go through the door. No need to wait for opening the door, because this is faster. Go through the blind spot. Here once again, 1337. For this entire passage, the code is 1337. It's really nice. Some AI manipulation, so they never saw me coming, haha. Bye. And yeah, this is server manufactory. Just going past and passing everyone. Taking the praxis kit, because we need it for later. There's a turret shooting at us, but we don't care. We just go further. Bam, 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 bam. Skip, skip. Here we go, and we're done. Vous avez le
typhoon? Oui, mais vous aviez raison. Il se passe quelque chose de louche. J'ai sur les bras un puriste mort. Avec de superbes implants cérébraux. Ne le touchez
pas. It felt like some top tier shit back then. Yeah, good old times.
Entendu. Qu'est-ce que je fais pour Sanders? Les gars du SWAT insistent
pour que je les laisse faire. And now we're running. So far this is a really good Seraph Manufactory. I got all the clips first try, so I'm really happy with that. Going up the stairs while having a revolver in my hand. Hi there. Just passing them by. So the AI is getting manipulated to go up, so we can just pass them. Really nice. Okay, I'm going to try a trick here. Let's see if it works. It's called the safe glitch, or like glitchy safe kind of like thing. Only that it works a bit differently. So we teleport into that room and skip a cutscene, which skips an info link, which I got. And so we can just leave the area.
Et pour les otages, voulez-vous que je... On ne peut plus rien pour eux.
Le SWAT n'a pas pu les sauver. Blah blah blah, blah blah blah, let's go. And that's it. That was Seraph Manufactory. Pretty nice. Can't complain. Happy so far. And now we're getting back to the headquarters. We need to give Pritchard the Typhoon, which they stole from us. And after that, we're going to leave and go into the police station. So yeah, if you have any questions about the Deus Ex games or the speedruns, just tell me. We have more downtime in Human Revolution compared to Deus Ex. And the same with Mankind Divided. Only that I didn't mention it before. But yeah. If there's anything, just tell me. Malik's belt. Yes. She has high pads on her legs, by the way. Really nice fashion. Blah 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 blah. Sure, let's go. Yeah, I'll show you the iPads she has on her legs. The future, man. In the future, you need to have iPads on your fucking legs. Because that is modern.
Madame Reed.
Blah, 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 blah. Blah, 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 except let's go. Hey, Kata. Speedrun it for 3 years. What is the most difficult Deus Ex to run? The Fall is pretty simple. Invisible War is really simple. Mankind Divided is super easy. Like, I got second place with my second run. And, well, that, I mean, it shows as well that the community is not really active with that game. Human Revolution and Deus Ex are more harder. And I would say that, well, both are pretty hard games. Whoops. I'm a bit confused. What do I get? I think I just need to get this. This is what happens if you run Mankind Divided and Human Revolution afterwards. Now I'm a bit confused what I need to augment. No, but I just need speed augmentation for now.
Pour l'instant.
Bien. Pour le moment, je veux connaître l'identité de ce cadavre.
So yeah, like, the thing is, like, Deus Ex has a really hard curve into starting to get into the speedrun. Like, you need to learn a lot of things and small details if you want to get good really quickly. But once you get that, it's super simple. Like, Deus Ex is just hard to learn at the start. It's the opposite with Human Revolution. Human Revolution is easier to learn, but to master it and do everything correctly is kind of hard. So both have, like, different ways how it handles. Like, Deus Ex gets easier with more practice. Human Revolution obviously too, but still you can fuck up little things which can screw you over even when you're more experienced. Right. So we run. He wants to talk with us. I don't want to talk with him. So I throw a bin at myself, crouch, and bam! Go out of bounds. Jump over. Sure. 9212. Go over. Take his brain.
Patron,
I totally like brains in this game.
On dirait qu'il a été modifié avec une sorte de disque chimio-organique. Pritchard devrait y jeter un coup d'œil.
Non, ne l'apportez pas ici.
Boy.
Frank est encore en pleine vérification. Et je ne veux pas risquer de connecter quoi que ce soit sur notre...
Oh my god, a guy with a gun.
Surtout s'il s'agit d'une technologie militaire. Alors qu'est-ce que j'en fais?
Rentrez à votre appartement avec le relais.
Yeah, we kill that cop outside because he has a shotgun and he can insta-kill us. So to make sure that we survive when we get out, because we have like a little cooldown where we can't move, and during that little cooldown where we can't move, he can immediately kill us. So just to make sure we don't die, we just shoot him in the head.
Jenny.
Rip.
Qu'est-ce qu'il voulait?
Elle a dit qu'elle aurait besoin d'un coup de main si vous pouviez aller jusqu'à Grand River Road. J'ajoute que même si je suis ravi de vous voir parmi nous, je n'ai pas l'intention de devenir votre secrétaire personnel.
Wow, this was the worst hopping I ever did.
Vous êtes où, Jensen? Je n'ai pas toute la nuit.
Bonjour, Pritchard.
Bonjour, Pritchard.
J'arrive à mon appartement.
Bon, quand vous y serez, branchez le relais neural sur votre
ordinateur. Relais neural.
J'ai créé une ligne sécurisée et j'interviendrai à distance.
Vous avez accès à mon ordinateur personnel?
Qui a configuré vos systèmes de sécurité, d'après vous?
Let's go to our own computer. And there's a little trick, I press the skip and disconnect button at the same time, so I don't need to stare at the computer, which is pretty nice. Then we continue. Take the elevator and leave. 420. Oh yeah, Jensen lives in an apartment 420, for those who realized it. We will see that later. I will show it later, because we are going to be back in Detroit.
D'accord, j'y vais tout de suite.
Yeah, I think I got only the jump height. Thanks for mentioning that. I forgot that this is an extra thing. Now we're going fast! This is what happens if you don't run a game for like 2 months. Now we're really fast. Thanks for mentioning that, Kata. But yeah, now we go to the Dero Ballers, which is like the gang territory. And here we do some AI manipulation. So those guys, we don't want them to see us at all, so I do some extra sound here and there, some extra jumps so that they don't see us. And then they will totally not see us coming. Pretty good. Best guards ever. Don't hire them. Whoop. Take this away. Then we take the grenades. And I hope you love physics, guys, because we're going to do something called the barrel boost. So I take the barrel, I throw it over there, take my barrel, put it on the tires, jump on it, throw a grenade, whee, and launch up in the air. Oh yeah, 5962, there you go.
Patron, est-ce que la bagnole est toujours ouverte?
Non, bien joué. Franck m'a dit que c'était réglé.
And while we have to wait for Malik to come over and pick us up, we're going to collect some mines. First mines. Second mines. Third mine. And fourth. They're all mines. No, but basically they're mine. Then we go here.
Monsieur Jensen, votre limousine est avancée. T'es prêt?
Ouais, allons-y.
Super. T3 local, ici Bravo Echo Echo 008 de Sarif Industries. Poursuivons le plan de vol.
Alright, now we're in FEMA. FEMA is pretty easy. And this is one of the levels where the the start and the end connect. And we're going to abuse that. So basically we're going to do this level backwards. Because we can. So we're going to take this, jump up, throw it in the corner, because the roof is not solid. Take the box with us, because we need the box. Box is love, box is life. Choop-de-doop. Throw it over. Throw it over again, take it, throw it against ourselves, and clip through this wall. Boom. Activate the trigger so it can go through this door. Save, line up. Ah, that was too bad. And now we clip through this elevator door. Ah, come on. I don't want to get in this corner, I want to get in this middle. Game, please. There you go. And before we land, we get Icarus. So we don't get any fall damage. Haha, and survive. Okay, hardest boss fight incoming. Are you guys ready? Prepare yourself. It's really tough. 1, 2, 3. Boom! That's it. That was the boss fight.
Jensen, comment ça se passe de ton côté? Ces soldats viennent de filer sans demander leur reste.
Pretty good, eh?
Ils t'ont vu?
Non, j'étais tout feu éteint au cas où ça chaufferait. Tu vas bien?
Ça va.
More love than a companion cube, definitely.
Va à la ZA, je te récupère là-bas.
And now we wait. I think I need to prepare some elevator music for this part. Okay, this guy has a grenade I really want, so I did not get his EMP grenade. Are you kidding me, game? Sure, there, sure. I thought I turned this off. Because I re-locked in, I did not get it. Okay, sure, so we don't have an EMP grenade now, because the game decided to not give me that. This is really cool.
Mais je dois d'abord faire mon rapport.
Really nice of you, game. So now I need to think of a fly where I can get another EMP grenade. Victor is still harder. Blah blah blah. We don't want to talk with him. Turn off your friends, yes. Because it reactivated once I had to restart Steam. Thanks to Mankind Divided Safe Corruption on Steam. Good shit. Okay, now we go to Francis and talk with him.
Dépêchez-vous.
Que voulez-vous?
Salut.
Let's get ready. And now we go to Hengsha, which is one of the smaller and cooler areas. Very short and really cool, because you basically need to go to Tong, you need to do the mission, you need to find the hacker, but that's all way too boring. So what I'm going to do is just go to the exit and clip myself through the subway, and that works. So we go over here. Rare box friends. Good throw. Totally good throw. Throw it over. Make sure it does not get stuck. Did not get stuck, good job. Throw it over here. Throw it over there. Throw it to the Taeyong Medical Station. And do a box clip. There you go. And buy Hengsha. That was basically it. Ba-ba-da-ba.
Malik, les nouvelles de Pritchard?
Je suis là, Jensen.
I think there was like an EMP grenade here. Nope.
Parfait.
Il faut another scanner here.
Un terminal de sécurité
nope.
Dans la tour de la ville.
All right. That is really nice of the game not giving me the EMP grenade, even though I killed the merchant and took it. But oh well. I need to think of something on the fly. We accept his request, but we're not going to help him. Rip that guy. There's a guy who wants to talk with us, but we don't want to talk with him, so I shoot at the door. He got hostile, so he's going to activate the AI here, which is kind of unfortunate. But still, it shouldn't be a problem. Shooting. Still shooting. That's not nice. Alright. And next coming up is a really, really cool trick, which we call the TYM boost, Taeyong Medical boost. What I need for that is another mine, and I think I know where there is an EMP grenade. I need to check though. Where I need the mine and a fire extinguisher. So, just jumping up. going to open this big elevator door, take the fire extinguisher with me, and do this. Okay, now we're going to learn the typhoon. And the typhoon allows us to go out of bounds, and we're going to abuse that, so you will see soon.
Une salle de très haute sécurité. C'est quelques niveaux au-dessus du palier où votre ascenseur s'arrête. Mais les premiers couloirs que vous traverserez sont publics, alors ne sortez pas votre arme.
Bien reçu.
All right. So the setup is the following. Put that here. Close the door, take it, jump on the button, turn around, get the fire extinguisher out of bounds or not. Good job. Like this. Bam. Take it there. Go yourself out of bounds. Because for some reason the typhoon allows you to go backwards and upwards, and we're abusing that. So bam, we're out of bounds. Then we take the fire extinguisher up here, align it correctly, like this. Yep, that's good. Put a mine there. And whee! Fly up high. This is basically the Taeyong medical boost, and because the game was refusing me to give me my EMP grenade, I'm going to get myself a EMP grenade. There was no... No? Okay. Whoop! Just going to check here, otherwise I have an idea what I can do. Just really... really angry that the game decided to take my EMP mine from or my EMP grenade from me, which I need for this coming up part. That annoys me a bit, but it's fine. I know what I can do. Yeah, never loading time. That's fine. I know what I can do. It will just be super slow. And as said, it annoys me a bit that the game decided to take my weapon or like my stuff from me. But it's fine. So now we're waiting. Door open. Still riding the elevator. Yeah, the game or Team Revolution and Mankind Divided love elevators. There you go. There might be a chance that there is an EMP here, but whatever. Alright. So what we're going to do now is we manipulate the AI, throw them a blinding grenade, so they're all going to not shoot at us. And then we take our leave. Goodbye. I mean, what I could do is use the rocket launcher to kill one of the robots. But it's so old school, I don't really want to do that. Or should I do that? A little bit of action? Because normally you just need the EMP grenade. So what you do is throw an EMP grenade and then one over. Which I can't do right now because, well, as said, I miss one. Thanks to the game not giving it to me. But it's fine because there is another EMP grenade here. So I'm just going to throw it over. And it didn't work. Good job. This is not how you do strats. Thank you, game. Yeah, that is Lord Loken. You're talking about extruders. Hunk of junk. There you go. Alright. Super advanced. Future strats. Take this. Alright. Slow as hell, but it's fine. I mean, I can take an EMP mine for later, so we're still safe. Just annoyed as sad that the game decided to not give it to me.
Jensen, il est temps de repartir à Détroit. Grimpe!
On ne va pas à Détroit.
Quoi ?
Direction Montréal. Je t'expliquerai en chemin.
T'as intérêt.
And boom. That was Taeyong Upper. Now we're going to my favorite part, which is Pike's communication. So this game, or this area, is really, really broken. So what we're going to do is, we go out of bounds this way. And instead of going down the normal way, we're just going to skip the entire thing. And go to the funicular immediately. Which is, bam, here. So we skipped the entire part, we skipped triggers, no enemies are here, nobody to worry about. Really nice, and now we clip into the elevator. So we just do it like this. Sure game. It worked, but it didn't work. Right. When I go here, crouch, and bam. Now I'm halfway through the door, and I need to wiggle a bit around to get through the second layer, which is a bit harder. Boom, there you go, and done. We skipped more than half of a level. Now go downstairs, and going downstairs takes quite a while. So nothing I can do about here.
Je pense à la facilité avec laquelle
headshots.
Ils peuvent pirater leur pare-feu et accéder à leur système informatique.
I mean, headshots can still be lethal takedowns.
Où vous voulez en venir?
J'ai le sentiment d'être conduit vers certaines zones de leur réseau et tenu à l'écart d'autres. Seulement, il n'existe aucun système de sécurité capable d'improviser ça.
Vous y réfléchirez plus tard, Richard. Si je veux mettre la main sur Miss Kassan, il va me falloir des coordonnées plus précises que dans le repère secret.
Le nuage d'holo-imagerie que vous avez rencontré dans la salle 404 a correspondu à un pic de consommation électrique. Celui-ci était situé dans une des plus grandes salles du sous-sol, 80211. D'après moi, c'est de là
qu'elle est. Some news here. Bigfoot spotted in Saskatoon. Woman claims 7-foot giant ate berries from backyard trap. Really good news. Stay tuned to Pikus for additional coverage. Sure. Oh, are we there yet? Are we there yet? Yay, we're there. I think here was an MP grenade. There you go. Alright. We're back on track. Okay, normally we're supposed to skip those guys immediately, but because I had to take up the grenade and I didn't know where it is, it took quite longer. So we're just going to do this part again, which is fine because the game is luckily nice with that save. For some reason they saw me though again. Interesting, but not a problem. So we take the box here, do this, and clip ourselves through. Bye. And go now to the end boss. Not end boss, but like to the boss, which is Yelena. And she's pretty easy, kind of like with Barrett. So what we're going to do, throw one grenade in front. She's totally going to run into it. Did not see that coming. And we're done. That was Yelena. Now we go here. Trigger the helipad. And while doing so, we're just going to collect stuff. Energy cells. Food, hypostim, like the healing item, that's why I have 142 HP, and we're going to take our leave and go back to Detroit 2.
Jensen, Elisa Kassan vient de me contacter et m'a dit de te retrouver ici. T'es prêt à partir?
Oui, à la maison, Malik.
Ah, c'est pas trop tôt.
And we go. Yep, that was Pikus. Okay, since elevators are really, really slow in this game, we're going to take something which is faster, and I like to call it the Fire Extinguisher Express. So we take the fire extinguisher, throw it into that corner. Wow, that was a nice slide. Go into the corner, throw it against yourself. Up, take it outside, and it didn't work. Good job, Jensen. He overshot it. But basically, I would stay on the fire extinguisher and take the fire extinguisher down, because it's faster than doing the Icarus landing. by 6 to 7 seconds. And it is really cool to see that there is a physics glitch, because the item does not recognize that you're staying on the item, and thanks to that, you're just like staying on the item, taking no damage, and you can just do it whenever you want. Like, we did it previously in, as a strat, but we don't do it anymore. Then there is a basketball court. But, oh look, a box. What could I do with that? Taking the box with us. Throwing it over. Bam. Jumping ourselves over here. And now we're going to skip like an entire discussion and go immediately to Seraph Manufactory. Not Seraph Manufactory, but Seraph Headquarters. And this is pretty cool, because you are not supposed to go through the door here at all. You're not supposed to be in this area at all. However, the trigger to go inside is still active. And if you do that, the script is loading the level and triggers like, aha, you are in Detroit 2. So we're going to load the next script, which should normally happen because you get flying in. But because we trigger it from the outside, the game is just loading it like if we did everything before, even though we did not. So right now, we're inside, we skipped everything, and the game is just progressing because it says like, yep, you're done with it. Good job. You did well, player. And now we wait, because another elevator. So he wants to talk with us, but we don't want to talk with him. And we take our leave. Blah blah blah, let's go, and whoop, we're done. That was Detroit 2. Okay, Heng Sha. So we're going into getting into an ambush, but that's not a problem for us because we're super cyborg. So we just turn invisibility on and run through. Nothing to worry about, they're not even going to hit us. Excuse me. Stop shooting at me. Ah, I couldn't do this cutscene clip. Thanks to that guy shooting. But yeah.
Malik?
Rip Malik! Bible fun! Malik! No! I wanted to skip this, but it didn't work. And did that guy just. Clip for. Malik! No!
Farida!
Farida! Rest in peace, Farida.
Jensen, j'espionne les communications dans la zone de Heng Sha. Bell Tower vous cherche, c'est du sérieux.
Ces salauds nous attendaient, Pritchard.
And yeah, this part is pretty straightforward. Not a lot of things happening. Just go to from A to B, from B to C, and you're done.
Mais s'ils vous voient, s'ils vous
connaissent, it's pretty straightforward.
Évitez-les autant que possible. L'Organisation mondiale de la santé recommande à tous les gens augmentés d'aller passer un examen de contrôle dans les cliniques en plib.
A lot of jumping. There's going to be a guy. Wow. There's going to be a guy who wants to talk with me, but nope, I don't want to talk with him, so I'm just going to skip him by turning invisible. Kind of the same trick you do in Mankind Divided, and both works. Really nice. So at least that is consistent. And now we're going to the sewers. Because in the sewers there is Tong, who we met before, which you never met before, because, well, we skipped him. Hidaro doesn't want to talk with us, so his info link gets interrupted. And then we're going down here. Here we just turn invisible, so that the guards are not seeing us. Alright. And now we go to Tong and get the best weapon in the game. Super overpowered and broken. It's called the laser rifle. So we go through here. Never saw me coming. And ta-da! Blah 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 blah. Alright, give me the laser gun. There you go. Now we experience story-wise glitches where you can go to the limb clinic to get healed. However, this is a trick, so the Namir boss fight would be harder. But if you don't go, then everything will be fine. So we don't go, well, obviously because it's too slow on one hand, and obviously because it's a trick. But nothing to worry about. Did I miss much? No, we're almost at the end. We're almost in Singapore, so like around a minute, then we're done with Heinki 2. Brain farting pad. Wow. Then we just use the hippostim to heal ourselves, so we don't get a lot of damage. And then we take the bomb. Oh my god, bomb! Turn invisible to avoid the robot. And then we go into this building. 5489. Eat a jar of candy to get our energy back. And then 3295. Go in here. Excuse me. Yes. Place the bomb. And done with Detroit 2. Now we're going to be in Singapore. Pilot always dies. No, not always. Well, okay, Jock died and Malik died, but the other guy in Mankind Divided does not die. So where's that? Then we do another box clip here, just because it's faster and more convenient. Just pass them. Nothing to see, nothing to worry. Hey, Monzeros, Sirius, what's up? Take another box, throw it over, where's the little bot? Doesn't matter. Throw it over. Throw it over. Throw more over. And now, okay, we're going to do a trick in which we skip Namir entirely. So I don't feel like doing Namir. And the old strat of doing Ylmir. That's another runner, by the way. The way how to do Namir is basically, you punch him in the face. So that is the easiest strat. But we do an out of bounds strat, so we're out of bounds, and now I'm walking out of bounds to the end door. So I'm hitting a wall, and now I go there. Okay, basically you don't know what is going on, but there is a door, and hey, we skip the entire boss fight. So all you have to do is go straight forward, turn 90 degrees to the left, go forward, and you're done. And that's basically what I did. Hold out of bounds. So yeah, we never see Namir. We entirely skip him. Doctor is going to trip. Whoop. And yeah, Singapore. Pretty good stuff.
On reparlera de ça toi et moi, Megan.
Les apparences sont contre moi, mais arrête d'abord le signal. Je pense que les biopuces saturent le nerf pneumogastrique, ce qui doit créer d'horribles hallucinations.
Tu veux dire que ça va rendre fou les gens augmentés?
Oui.
Jensen left the game.
La navette Léo te conduira à Panchaya. Bonne chance, Adam.
Okay, press the button. Total of world destruction. Hell yeah.
Trajectoire sous-orbitale calculée. destination, Panchaya. Début du compte à rebours, monsieur Darrow.
Affirmatif.
Code 000, confirmé 0. Début du compte à rebours.
Alright, final area coming up, which is Panchaya. Yeah, we play the game in French because the French version is 10 seconds faster.
Jensen.
The door is on the other hallway, so the thing is just that the geometry is not loading, like the textures are not loading, because you did not hit the level trigger. However, because we know where to go, we can just go there invisible, and that's what we basically do. We navigate through that entire stage without knowing where we are, but have like indications. Like, I use the hills in the skybox in the background, so I know where to go. Zero. Confirmative zero. Okay, so this is a big skip. So what we're going to do is we get a box. Hey, where's my box? And now we're doing a combination of a box clip and the typhoon one. Because this is a bit harder. Normally you can't do a box clip through this door. And the loading trigger is upstairs. So we hit that trigger because the typhoon is pushing us up, back and upstairs, or up. And because of that, we hit the trigger and load this area. So we don't need to talk with Darrow and get his destruction code at all, which is really nice. And yeah, that out of bounds skip just saves 15 seconds to the regular punch Namir in the face strat. So it's not that fast, but it's still cool. No, I didn't pick up French. I will not. I'm more interested in Russian and Chinese. Both are really hard languages. So, yeah, I'm interested in both languages. I had Spanish in school. I was forced to take it. I don't wanted to learn it, so I never really learned it. Oh, wasted potential and wasted time. But long live the school system. Either way, that's a different discussion. So right now, we're almost at the end. There are a lot of crazy people. The thing is, they can slow you down, so you need to be careful. For some reason, their gloves have a slowdown effect. Or they put it into poison, I don't know. Yeah, like right now. Now I'm slowed. I can't run anymore, so I need to be lucky to not get hit, so I can run. Please, game, let me run. There you go. Don't understand why they did that, or what the reason is that they can do it, but they can do it. Okay, so another out-of-bounds clip. To skip the elevator of shame. Basically, before we had to take this elevator, which took like 2 minutes, and it was just super slow. However, we can shock ourselves to deactivate the Icarus landing system, and then we just go to the end door. We won't see anything. Like, everything will be white for a while. Now I go forward, press E, and we're at the final boss. Ta-da! And now we do the final boss. Oh my god, this fight is really good. Okay. Boss is done. That was the final boss. The laser rifle is super overpowered. So make yourself ready for time. That was pretty good. Blah blah blah. Push button. Best ending. Afin d'assurer que la prochaine génération puisse prospérer librement. C'est bien ce que vous voulez? And time. Yeah. Pretty good. Well, the run was pretty bad thanks to the game screwing me over and not giving me my MP grenade. But all in all, I'm okay with that. So yeah, those were the Deus Ex game. Deus Ex, Human Revolution, Mankind Divided. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for the marathon. Remember that your donations are going for a good cause. Enjoy it, and have a good time, guys. Enjoy your weekend. See you next time, probably in chat. And yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. So, this is from my side. So, until next time.
Thanks, Heinki, for your run, man. For your runs.
You're welcome.